Is it challenging to get to Jupiter? Why have we never seen its interior? Jupiter is the most visited gaseous planet of all. Throughout the history of space exploration, it has been visited by 9 spacecraft. However, so far only one ship has managed to cross its dense atmosphere to observe its interior. Is it tough to land a spaceship on Jupiter? What's inside the gas giant? Ready? Let's get started. The problem with speed. Jupiter is the 5th closest planet to the Sun, but it is not so complicated to get there despite being very far away. Because of the fact that it is the planet with the highest mass, its gravitational attraction force is vast, and thanks to that, spaceships do not work hard once they enter its gravitational field. But this is also a problem. Getting to Jupiter is relatively easy, but putting something into orbit around the giant planet is a more significant challenge. In 1979, the Voyager space probe took 1,546 days to reach Jupiter, but to get so far, the spacecraft had to acquire a very high speed. A trip traveling so fast cannot remain in orbit around any planet since it will follow its course. To place a spacecraft in orbit around any celestial body, it must adjust its speed. It must not go too fast to escape the gravitational pull, or too slow to be trapped by gravity and plunge into free fall towards the surface of the planet. The Voyager probe was too fast to be captured by Jupiter's gravity. To get into orbit, it would have to make use of rockets to help it slow down slowly, but at that time, the Voyager probes did not have such rockets equipped. Future missions that reached Jupiter did count on these rockets to slow down and enter orbit around the gas giant. Requirements to reach Jupiter successfully. In general, flights to other planets in our solar system are accompanied by high energy expenditures. For a spacecraft to reach Jupiter's orbit from Earth, it requires about the same amount of energy that it would require to lift it off from Earth's surface and place it in low Earth orbit. However, gravitational assistance can sometimes be used to help space probes, requiring less energy at launch, although this procedure significantly increases the time of the mission, which eventually means that the spacecraft must be equipped with some resource that allows it to replenish energy during the long journey, either with solar panels or thermal nuclear energy sources. An even bigger problem is that Jupiter has no solid surface on which to land. Because of its gaseous composition, there is a smooth transition from its atmosphere and its inner fluid. But the atmosphere is so large and heavy that any space probe descending through Jupiter's atmosphere would eventually be destroyed by the immense pressure and reduced to dust. Another problem is the amount of radiation a probe is exposed to reaching the planet, given the harsh particle charges around Jupiter. For example, the Galileo probe has orbited it for several years and has had markedly exceeded the amount of radiation for which it was designed. As a result, the scanning probe has suffered various technical problems and failures attributed to unrepaired radiation effects. Our visits to Jupiter, Pioneer 10 and 11, 1973 and 1974. Pioneer 10 was the first space probe to explore Jupiter, which did so in December of 1973, followed by Pioneer 11 13 months later. The Pioneer 10 probe was the first spacecraft in history to take the first images of Jupiter from up close, thanks to which we could observe that Jupiter was covered with storm clouds that could not be seen clearly from Earth. Pioneer 10 also took images of the Galilean satellites Europa, Io, Callisto, and Ganymede. It observed its atmosphere and radiation belts, which extended several thousand kilometers from the planet. Thanks to this mission, Jupiter's magnetic field was detected, which extends so far that all the solar system planets could fit inside it. Another discovery that we owe to the Pioneer probes is that, thanks to temperature lenses, it was possible to corroborate that Jupiter is mainly liquid. That is to say that instead of being called a gaseous planet, it should be called a liquid planet, since its main composition is metallic liquid hydrogen. Pioneer 11 was the first probe to take sharp images of the Great Red Spot. It made the first observations of its polar regions and obtained the first close images of the satellite Callisto, which is wholly covered with active volcanoes. Voyager 1 and 2, 1977 and 1979. The famous Voyager exploration probes traveling to the solar system's far reaches also used Jupiter's gravity to gain speed. Voyager 1 began photographing Jupiter in January of 1979 and made its closest approach on March 5th, 349,000 kilometers from the planet's center. Because of its higher resolution and shorter distance, most observations of moons, rings, magnetic fields, radiation, and the environment were made during the 2 days the probe was closest to the planet. The Voyager missions improved the understanding of the Galilean satellites. They contributed to the discovery of the rings of Jupiter that, until then, no one had seen because they are too thin to be detected with a telescope from Earth. Before the Voyager missions, Saturn was believed to be the only planet with asteroid rings. The probes took the first images of its atmosphere and revealed that the Great Red Spot is an anti-cyclone moving counterclockwise, in addition to other smaller storms near the main one. These missions discovered the Adrastea and Metis satellites orbiting close to Jupiter's rings, being the first moons of that planet to be discovered by a spacecraft. The third was Thebe. Together, the two Voyagers recorded great volcanic activity on the Io satellite, a total of 9 volcanic eruptions with evidence of others occurring between the encounter with the two probes, an unexpected discovery concerning Jupiter and becoming the first observation of active volcanoes in another planet besides Earth. In Europa, hundreds of lines were discovered and initially considered acts attributed to tectonic movements. However, thanks to the photography of Voyager 2, it was determined that the true origin of these cracks was because Europa is a moon with geological activity, and that it has at least 30 kilometers of crust in the form of a thick layer of ice. It is currently thought that beneath all of Europa's ice, there could be an ocean of liquid water. Ulysses, 1992. The Ulysses spacecraft was designed as a 5-year mission to study the sun's never-before-examined North and South Poles. Ulysses became one of the most prolific contributors to knowledge of the solar wind, interstellar dust, and the three-dimensional character of solar radiation, far exceeding the lifespan of its planned mission by 13 years, and collecting treasure troves of data on the solar wind, interstellar dust, and the solar activity cycle. The spacecraft also performed several technical feats, including an unprecedented gravitational assist maneuver on Jupiter to launch out of the elliptical plane and enter its solar polar orbit. After the probe's launch, Ulysses headed to Jupiter. It arrived in February of 1992 for the gravity assist maneuver that placed the spacecraft into its unique solar orbit that no other spacecraft had done before. Thanks to this, the probe managed to leave the plane of the ecliptic, where all the planets rotate and pass over the south pole of the sun in 1994. And the North Pole in 1995. Beginning its second orbit of the Sun, Ulysses revisited the South Pole in 2000 and the North a year later. At the time, the Sun was near the peak of its 11-year activity cycle. Ulysses then returned to Jupiter's orbit on the long stretch of its 6-year circuit around the Sun. The mission ended on June 30, 2009, after disconnecting the probe remotely, unable to carry out further significant scientific activities due to the depletion of its nuclear power source. Galileo, 1995. So far, Galileo has been the only space mission to venture deep into Jupiter. During the mission, a large amount of information was gathered about the planet and its system. However, it was not as large as expected due to a failure in deploying the probe's transmitting antenna. Significant events during the 8 years the mission covered included multiple flybys of all Galilean moons, including Almathea, the first probe to do so. In part, it witnessed the impact of comet Shoemaker-Levy 9 as it approached Jupiter in 1994 and sent back atmospheric proof of the planet in December of 1995. An atmospheric probe was deployed from Galileo in 1995, which entered the planet's atmosphere on December 7th of that year. After descending with an immense G-force, it was destroyed by atmospheric pressure and temperature after crossing 150 kilometers of the atmosphere and collecting data for 57.6 minutes. The probe was subjected to 22 times the Earth's temperature at 153 degrees Celsius. It is believed that the probe was melted down and probably evaporated by the high temperatures turning it to dust. Later, the Galileo probe ran with the same fate, although more quickly, after being deliberately directed towards the planet at 50 kilometers per second. To prevent any failure to cause the probe to fall on the satellite Europa, contaminating it with human space debris. Among the scientific results obtained by Galileo is the first observation of ammonia clouds in the atmosphere of a planet other than our own. The atmosphere creates clouds of ammonia ice from materials from the depths. It also confirmed the extensive volcanic activity that was suspected on Io, 100 times greater than the Earth, considering the heat and its frequency as an example of what the Earth was in the past. On this moon, it also observed the complex plasma interactions of the atmosphere, which gives rise to electric currents similar to Earth's thunderstorms, but thousands of times larger. It also provided evidence confirming the existence of a liquid ocean under Europa's surface ice. It made the first detection of a large magnetic field around a satellite, Ganymede, something completely unexpected, since until then, it had never been seen that a satellite could have such a large magnetic field. The Galileo probe also provided evidence of magnetic fields suggesting the presence of salty oceans beneath the surface of Europa, Ganymede, and Callisto, as well as a thin atmospheric layer on all three moons, called the exosphere, indicating that all three satellites have a high probability of harboring both liquid water and possible living things inside. Cassini-Hyugens, 2000. In 2000, on its journey to Saturn, Cassini-Hyugens approached the planet, providing some of the highest quality images of Jupiter to date. One of the main findings of the space mission was announced on March 6, 2003, about the atmospheric circulation of Jupiter. The dark belts alternate with the illuminated areas of the atmosphere. For a long time, scientists believed that the areas, with their pale clouds, were the regions from which air emerged into the outer atmosphere, similar to how it happens on Earth. However, analysis of Cassini-Huygens images show that individual storm cells arise in bright white clouds, too small to be seen from Earth. New Horizons, 2007. On its journey to Pluto, New Horizons approached Jupiter for gravitational assistance. While on Jupiter, it made detailed measurements of the inner moons, in particular, Almathea. It measured the volcanoes of Io and studied the Galilean satellites, as well as other moons such as Himalaya and Alara. The probe also studied the planet's little red spot, magnetosphere, and thin ring system, as well as taking infrared images that help better understand its atmosphere. Juno, 2011. The last mission to reach Jupiter was Juno. This probe was designed to study the planet's atmosphere, origin, structure, and evolution within the solar system, and thus better understand its formation. Its main functions are focused on creating a study and map of gravity in its magnetic fields, Jupiter's auroras, and its magnetosphere. It will also study clues about the planet's formation, its core, water in the atmosphere, its mass, and its winds, which can reach speeds of up to 618 kilometers per hour or 384 miles per hour. Currently, the Juno probe continues to orbit Jupiter on a safe trajectory that protects it from the intense radiation emitted by the gas giant, and is expected to continue operating for at least 6 more years. When Juno's mission ends, it will have the same fate as Galileo. It will intentionally crash into Jupiter so that it does not contaminate other satellites, such as Europa, which can harbor water. According to experts, future missions to Jupiter will not be to study the gas giant, but to study its moons. In fact, the European Space Agency already has a date for such a mission, and it is called JUICE, which means Jupiter Icy Moons Explorer. A mission that will take off in April of this year and that will aim to make a detailed observation of the gas giant planet and its three large oceanic moons, Ganymede, Callisto, and Europa, with a set of remote sensing instruments for organic matter. The mission will characterize these moons as planetary objects and possible habitats that could be humanity's following settlements. Would you like us to make a video about the future JUICE mission that will explore Jupiter's moons? Let us know what you think in the comments.